approximately 6.5 inches or 16 centimeters. This is the updated version, this new one here, which we'll compare and contrast in a minute, to the older version of G.I. Joe Classified Series Roadblock. One of the very first figures in the G.I. Joe Classified line came out with, to some fans' distaste, not mine, but to some fans' distaste, a kind of more sci-fi element where they had, if we zoom in just a little bit, you'll see what I mean, kind of silver elements, a little kind of slightly space age effect. I mean, that is Joe in many ways. Weapons and armor that just felt a little bit kind of these gold kind of elements here, and that's principally the kind of key differences in this figure. However, for some reason then Hasbro decided to maybe let's change things a little and keep it a little bit closer to classic Joes, and they agreed to they reissued the line back out again. Now all of them have came in separately from Hasbro as they redid them. I picked mine up at Darkside Toys, link to buy it from them in the description below. They kindly supplied, well, I kindly bought from them many times, the Lady J, the Flint, etc. All the kind of core characters, the first four, apart from Snake Eyes, really, he was the same. So these guys all got a bit of a makeover. I've reviewed all of them before. There's not a great deal of difference here, but I just thought for completeness, I shall show you the differences. First of all, there is no difference in the packaging, and if you look at it, you'll see it uses the exact same packaging and art. So all the kind of colouring, the silver, etc., the gold, it's not there anymore. So it's slightly different. Yeah, nothing different on the packaging. It's the same number one in the line. So packaging, no flavour difference whatsoever. But these two figures are now Rocket Launcher on his back is my own, and I kind of chopped this weapon here, but let me just zoom in a little bit to show you the difference. For example, so the new weapon here, which I really don't like at all, period, but you can see the new weapon, it's solid black compared to the silver here with the red and the blue. This bit I chopped off, it's just far too big a weapon, but nothing dramatically changed on this one here. It was just silver all the way with a little bit of this blue effect there too. It is definitely a kind of sci-fi looking weapon. I just felt that worked a little bit more to have it at that size, to chop that kind of section off. But that's the weapon, as you can see. So we're getting less paint. So it just feels weird, this kind of retrofying and kind of, I don't know. Anyway, closer look again. Just let's have a look at the facial sculpts to see if any difference. There really, as far as I could tell, was none. My brother from another mother. There is no difference really in paint on these two. This is perhaps a little bit darker skinned, more slightly darker in paint than this one. But beard the same, the shininess is the same. I thought they would have improved that a little bit. It's a bit too much lip balm. This one's definitely got it going on heavy. You can see again just on the shoulders. So what is gold and blue is just now grey. Tattoos remain the same, there's no difference on those. The what was red on the gloves is now black. On the back, as you'll see again, just remove the paint, really. There's no major difference. When it comes down to the front of the boots, you'll see what was red and gold is just now black. If we turn to the back of the knives, what was silver before is now jet black. The red is still there, they kept that, but that kind of gold around there has been removed. So it's kind of, and again, the glove. So really not a great deal of difference. I really expected more, but that's it. Just little tweaks to make them a little bit less kind of futuristic. I personally prefer this one. What do you think? New updated version here, or the older original 01 version? Subtle little thing, but I thought we'd do a video just to show you, because I've done it for all the other three. So yeah, let us know what you think. And we'll see you for more G.I. Joe reviews coming up soon. Cheers.